So now we're going to take a look at a different piece of technology, a piece of technology you use just about every day, I wager. We've opened it up so you can see what's going on inside. But again, it's a technology that makes use of polarized light. So we have another one of our chimneys here with an incandescent light bulb in between. I'm going to polarize the light coming out of that with one of my handy little red marked polarizers. And we've got this piece of glass and mystery material above it. And I'm now going to hold up another polarizer that I've got the other red mark on, and I'm going to orient so it's at 90 degrees. Well, that's interesting. It's at 90 degrees. Oh, there he is. Yeah, you see, that causes extinction if I just go directly to the lower polarizer. But if I have it on above this mystery piece of material, it doesn't go to zero. I've got the polarized crossed, but I can actually see something going through there. That's because the mystery material in here is something called a liquid crystal, which has been twisted, and it has the property that it can actually rotate the direction of the polarization of the light. So the polarization, the light that got through this polarizer gets rotated, so by the time it gets to this position, it can actually get through a polarizer at 90 degrees with respect to it. But the interesting thing is, it's not just a passive piece of material. We've got some electrodes here, and if I apply a voltage to it, the way that liquid crystal rotates the polarization changes. I can actually reorient the molecules inside so it doesn't rotate the polarization. And in the places where those electrodes reorient the molecules, I now don't get light through. Again, I have to have the polarized crossed to be able to see the display, and I have to put on the electric field to go from clear to dark. This is something called a liquid crystal display, and is in the panels of most of your calculators, digital watches, and the same sort of technology shows up in the screens of many TVs and smartphones these days.